gonna get them, okay? Now, the thing is, I want to talk a little bit about the condom situation, okay? Because it related to today's lesson and related to meaning therapy, okay? Now, I watch condom situation closely every day. Yeah, just a discussion with Nelson. It, because I'm from Hong Kong, and it really affects me to see young people protesting, getting beaten up, you know, with tear gas, with bullets, rubber bullets, with baton. And then there's an old man called Grandpa Wong, 85 years old. He was king to block the baton to protect children. He didn't want to protect my children. Okay? So people ask me, what will you do? Okay? Here's my answer. If it's related to meaning therapy, okay? Here's my answer. I say, I accept the fact that one country, two system policy will end in 24/7. That's a fact, okay? The system only lasts 50 years. So it will end. So you by 2047, Hong Kong will work with China, as well as sit in China, to one country, one system. And I also accept the fact that Hong Kong is so tiny, so small, depending on China for water, for everything. There's no way you can fight the big China next door. It's not possible to fight, okay? So this is acceptance, okay? But acceptance doesn't mean surrender, okay? Don't surrender. Doesn't mean resignation. When Frankl was in Nazi concentration camp, there's no way he can win by fighting German army, okay? I mean, it's gun and everything. I mean, no way he can fight. But he said that there's one freedom that no one can take away from me, the freedom of attitude. No one can take my, it's about, you got to have a defined attitude. Every healthy person should be a rebel at heart, against evil, against totalitarianism, against unfairness, against injustice, against all evil forces. We should have the thing called the defined power of human spirit. It's that defined power of human spirit that keeps it going in Nazi concentration camp. So freedom and ability is a cornerstone of the therapy. But you accept the fact that the evil forces are much stronger than the political Hong Kong, political me. But I'm still, if I were Hong Kong, I would be another Grandpa Wong with my cane and people. I'll be there. So that's my prelude. Those of you have three basic tenets, three basic cornerstones. The first one is freedom and ability. The big assumption is that human beings have the capacity for freedom. That's the cornerstone. You have no freedom to choose. We need that end of story. You are slave, you are slave, you obey. If you obey, then that's you have no choice. There's no possibility for human health. For mental health. The mental health is based on the idea that you want to live an authentic life, you want to live a meaningful life, you choose your own path. So that's why for the second cornerstone is when you have choice, you choose meaning. The third tenet is that meaning can be found. That should be with the tenet of the therapy. Freedom of choice, you choose meaning and self-transcendence, The third that meaning can be found anywhere, even in the last minute of life. Okay, back to my lecture.
Thank you.
Now, natural way, being responsible is very different. I want to mention a little bit, okay? Natural way is still the best way. Natural way means not medicine. Natural way is not mean contrived, artificial way of doing things. Natural way is universal, it's part of human nature. Anyone can do it, okay? Anybody can benefit from it. In natural way, how do I know natural way? Because it's driven by evolution. If it's not adaptive, you'll not be there, right? It's driven by evolution, and it's proven by science. Okay, acceptance is proven by science. And also proven by human experience. And all major religion emphasize the importance of acceptance. So acceptance along with humility and courage, which is demonstrated in common situation, right? You need courage, you need responsibility, you do your part, but you also need to accept the fact that there will always be evil people, evil power, so you have to fight them yourself, right? You have to fight them. Life is a constant battle. Okay? Remember that life is kind of battle. If you want to live a worthy life, if you want to live with human dignity, okay? Of course, you surrender the slave, okay? I'm a happy slave. Just feed me, I'll obey. Sure, it's easy. A human being is not supported by a slave, okay? Acceptance is the crowning achievement of evolution. Let me explain to you why. At the physiological level, okay, at the physiological level, what is the basic mechanism for coping? Fight or flight, right? Approach, pressure, avoid pain, right? At the physiological level, the basic instinct. But that doesn't work. That doesn't work for human beings. It cannot help us cope with the terror of death. It cannot help us cope with horrors, right? Do you know what the terror of death? We're blessed with the intellect to anticipate our own demise. Our intellect to imagine the best thing to happen to us. Generate a lot of anxiety. Now, why are you so anxious? My wife is more anxious than I am. We're in the same situation, but she's always anxious about something. Maybe a woman is more anxious, I don't know why. Our intellect gets into trouble. We anticipate all kinds of dangers, anxiety. We anticipate we get sick, we die. We get so meaningless, terror of death. You can't run away from death. You can't run away from anxiety. There's no way to run away, so it doesn't work. And also, we can't run away from the horror of life, the calamities of nature, earthquake, typhoon, all kinds of natural disasters. Sometimes we can't run away from war, fighting many places. And there are betrayal, persecution, human trafficking, sick, the all kind of horrible things in life. You can't run away from them all. Where do you go? Where do you hide? So evolution process tell our ancestors, you can't run out of time. You can't run away from as your intelligence develop. You can imagine all kinds of things. Acceptance is one way to accept reality. That's why religion is the second part, trust, self-transcendence, it is related to acceptance. When they accept their own limitations, when they accept their own helplessness, They say, oh God, help us. Oh God, protect us. That's how religion started, right? Okay. Religion is also a natural way of coping. Acceptance and religious faith, the natural way of coping with terror and death. Acceptance is the most powerful adaptation response. You know how to accept yourself, you know how to accept others, you know how to accept the horrors of human existence, you'll change your life for good. Now here's an experiment, this is interesting, okay? They studied thing in UK, in London, okay, in 2014. They surveyed 5,000 people. They find out what kind of response, what kind of habit is most associated with overall well-being, overall happiness, action or happiness. Okay? Guess what? Acceptance found to be the action or habit that is most related to overall well-being. It supports my assertion, right? Acceptance is powerful. You know how to accept that you're the happiest human being. You can't accept, you'll be miserable. It's a fact. But there's a sad part about that. That's a paradox. Even though acceptance is the most powerful act to happiness, but only 5% of people who fully accept life. 5%! That's why it's difficult to learn, right? Most people still run away from problems rather than facing problems. They still run away from problems and solve the problem. Now here's another study, okay? The Harvard 2016, okay? Self-acceptance improved mental health, it means accepting all your attributes, good and bad. Accepting your body. I'm too short, I'm too fat, you can't accept your body. What do you do? Radical makeover? Eh? Is that an answer? You can accept your body. You can be miserable, right? You can't accept criticism to be miserable. There are always critics. I've been criticized by all kinds of people, but I'm still standing tall. You can't accept criticism. You can't accept your body. You'll be miserable, okay? Okay, the same, okay? But lack of acceptance is often unconscious. If your parents are not good, they're useless. The voice of my parents is suppressed, they're unconscious. So you fight with everybody to prove yourself. Because you can't accept yourself because of that negative voices in you. You're useless. Because your brother's smarter and no good. I can have more money. Your job. You look no big job. All negative voices. You suppress your unconscious. It's to affect you. Okay? So therefore, self-control. It's not that powerful, but self-control is based on unconscious. Conscious of control. Conscious of control cannot control the unconscious. So that's why sometimes people need therapy, okay? Now here's the book, Happiness, Acceptance, or Hang Hand. When you're happy, you accept yourself. Accept life. Accept medicine. That's the way to be happy. Okay? There's lots of evidence for that. No amount of self-improvement can make up for the lack of self-acceptance. I accept myself. God's spirit was absent. I can't help it, right? I accept the fact that I'm just an old man. I'm old, I can't pretend to be young, right? You know, I accept myself, I'm miserable. She's my woman, literally, right? Understanding is the first step to acceptance. What does it mean? You know, we talk about, meaning life. The first part of meaning life is what? Understanding, remember, pure. Understanding, purpose, understanding, reasonability, and enjoyment, right? So, understanding is part of meaningful life. You know why? You can't accept yourself if you do not understand, do not have the existential understanding that human life is fragile. That by nature, we're limited. We all come to this earth for a few years and we die. That reality. So if you understand that, if you understand human existence, then you're more willing to accept help from God, from other people. Mature happiness, again, is based on deep existential understanding of ontological reality, the reality of the nature of existence, okay? That life is such as the brevity and fragility of life, and accepting the dark side of the human condition, the dark side of your heart, the dark side of life. If you're not accepting all the bad things in life, you're doomed to a life of misery. And it's a paradox, right? You run away from them, you'll be miserable for life. You face them, you'll be happy. It's a paradox, right? Often your painful emotion reflect the dark side of your heart. Your anger, your shame, your desire to revenge, your poor self-esteem. When you're happy, when you point people at other people, I feel when you're happy. But actually, often painful emotions come within your own heart. Paradoxically, the moment we accept ourselves the way we are, with our premeditators, that is the first step to recovery. A lot of premeditated people, rather than looking in your own heart, you never get changed. You never get changed. Self-acceptance, okay? Here are seven best ways to maintain self-acceptance and self-esteem in the face of rejection and failure. First, try to believe that life has intrinsic value. There are research shown that teleological beliefs bring you a lot of comfort. Even for atheists, there's a lot of research I don't have time to turn to you, okay? You believe the life has meaning. You're born to say that life has meaning. You believe that, then you might be happier. Okay? And you also believe that doesn't matter what you're doing. You believe your potential for growth and make a difference. And they talk to me now, you know, I'm going to back to what can I do, blah, blah, blah. Do you know what? I used to be a janitor, do washrooms. I used to be a typist. I used to do all kinds of dirty jobs. I didn't go to university until I was 29. Imagine, I go to university, was an 18-year-old kid, but I never stopped believing that I can become a psychologist. not only psychologists, but a very influential psychologists. I never thought that. Third, yes. I also believe. Believe in God is also evolutionarily very adaptive. Even atheists, they know it's in foothold. Even atheists, one day they're desperate, oh God, help me. Believing God is adaptive, accepting God and give sense for being alive. The gratitude, I sense gratitude, which I done some research. You were able to give sense for being alive, you were alive to top. Thank you for joy. Do not negative things prevent you from striving towards goal. Seek through support. Achieve small successes. That's how you go. I tell you that, okay? They never give up, continue to strive toward what was it called, then you learn much better.